December the 23rd it is today. Lovely mild day actually. It's should be the depths of winter, but it doesn't feel like it. It feels like a nice autumn day, about 10 degrees, 12 degrees. It's only going to be 9 or 10 degrees at night, so it looks absolutely perfect. I'm here at the Secret Garden. This is my fourth trip now. I've done a spring, summer, autumn trip, so now it's time to do a winter trip and a Christmas trip. So it's going to be absolutely lovely here. It looks good, and hopefully there's going to be a fish or two along the way. Hopefully no deer this time. Last time I was here, I caught a deer. Well, who knows, maybe a reindeer this time. but no, hopefully a few carp. Like I say, it looks lovely. Rods are ready to go, so I'm going to get them baited up, get them out there, and see what happens. It is very mild and it looks very good for a fish or two. In fact, I'm almost sure I'm going to catch something. But it is winter and I know the fish haven't been fed for a week or two in here. And if it's anything like my pond at home, but the fish in there, they do get up and about when the weather's warmer. But during the winter, if you have a couple of cold spells and you stop feeding them, they do tend to switch off a little bit. So I'm going to go easy with the baiting to start with on here. I'm just going to use little 15mm wafters on a little size 8 claw, you know, just a little light, you know, 3 ounce in line, just a little simple rig, as always. And not over much bait, a few of the key cray pellets, a few little scopet squid, 12mm, and yeah, a little bit of hemp as well, but not much. Yeah, I'm just going to go in lightly and sort of gauge how it is really. For all I know, nothing might happen. But if it does, you know, if I get fish straight away, or a couple of fish, then I know they're hungry and start putting out more bait. At the moment, I don't know how it's going to go. So, you know, start off cautious and gauge the situation, basically. Lovely morning. It's been quite a mild night, and for December it's brilliant weather. Christmas Eve it is today, and it's been an eventful one. A couple of fish in the early hours, so I've kept them both for a couple of hours because it don't actually get light till nearly 8:30, so that's what it is now. And yeah, a couple of lovely fish. I mean, well, they're both 40s actually, and this one is 41 and a quarter. Absolute beauty, isn't it? But being my first 40 from the lake actually means it's also it's the 50th water that I've caught 40 pound carp from, which is a nice landmark to reach. And I was looking forward to coming here and hoping I was going to get a 40 to make this that special water. Fantastic. Sure. Did look bang on for it, and sure enough, see a few signs out there and put it to where I saw the fish. Just a little citrus wafter this was on, over a bit of scopet squid, a bit of key cray pellet, a little bit of hemp. Not loads, just a little bit. There we go, it did the job. We're off the mark with this cracker. Happy days. Happy Christmas. And here's the second one, like peas in a pod really. Very close scale. First one 41.4 and this one 41.8. I'll be honest, when I saw this one in the net, I thought it was going to be a lot bigger. Closer to 50 pound. It looks like a big chunk. But not like complaining. Two bites, two 40s. and on the same rod as well, actually. I had another drop take on the same rod, so they were all close to that far margin over there. But yeah, it's amazing how these fish are growing on. They're growing into proper big chunky lovely mirrors and commons now, and they're full winter weights, of course, but there's a lot of 40s in here now, a few up around 50 as well, just over. Oh, never make it easy, did I? But there we go, wouldn't have it any other way. Right, time to get him back and go in and get the kettle on and have a nice cup of tea, I think. Give me arms a rest for a minute. About 24 hours now since I first put the rods out, and this is, well, probably the fourth occurrence for three proper runs and one I think was an aborted take. Actually really fighting well, the fish, really strong. He's got three aerators, one over there by the pontoon and two down the other end, and it's a bit like an aquarium, you know, when you put an aerator in, the fish have bundles of energy. Oh, common, got a lovely dark common, looks nice. See the little citrus wafter hanging out of its mouth there. God, it's lovely, that does. Yes, lovely. Oh, that's beautiful. Christmas common. That's a nice fish and all. That's lovely. Well, what a result that was. I mean, it was a mega fight. I only just moved that rod this afternoon from sort of halfway across the lake to the far margin, which just looked better. And well, you saw the fight, it was a good battle. But I didn't expect it to be quite as big as what it is. Until this trip, I'd never had a 40 out of it. The first two fish were 40s. This one's gone one better, it's 50 pounder, 50 pound 8 ounce. What an absolutely beautiful common. John Noel, he was down earlier today and he did say there's five or six commons in here around 22 and a half kilos, which is high 40s, you know, up to about 50 pound. Well, this one's there just over 50. What a cracker, what an absolutely beautiful fish. Lovely dark in its winter colours. God, it looks so wide across the back looking from here. Little citrus wafter again over the Scopex and the pellet and a bit of hemp. Same as the other two, not loads, but just a nice little bit of bait. Enough to get a bite, as they say. God, I'm well happy with this one. Oh, Christmas fish, yes. And so Christmas Day arrived, and it was time to celebrate and eat some good food in the warmth of the house, of course. Now, owner Jean-Noël had decided to invite loads of friends and family down, which would make it a really nice day. All in all, there was 21 of us sitting down for dinner, and let me tell you, the dinner actually lasted for about 5 hours. But just as we sat down and started eating the first of the two or three starter courses, the sounder box let me know there was a fish on the other end, so we all raced out to see what I'd caught on Christmas Day. Would you believe it? Got the whole family down for Christmas dinner, and I've got to run. What a surprise!
It's a big mirror we don't see since 3 years.
It's moving very slowly.
Strong one as well, yeah.
I can't believe. Oh, la ligne, elle bouge. Ça, je me rappelle.
Well, happy Christmas, mate.
Caught the middle of a sunny afternoon. That's the last thing I thought.
I can't believe she saw
it. Yeah.
The girl.
Yeah. Fantastic.
You have a lot of technology, and she looks the line.
Perfect. Oh, hello.
Faut lui dire, elle viendra peut-être plus facilement.
Okay. Wee! Hey!
Congratulations, Steve.
Oh, merci.
I think it's a good fish, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
See now, I don't know if you can actually see this. I've just crept round the other bank with the pike rod, but I just spotted. I'll creep up here as quiet as I can with the GoPro on. Can you see them bubbles? See, that's exactly what I was talking about. There's fish out here, right, close to this far bank. See, I couldn't see that from the other side.
But that is definitely carp, that is. Just having a little fizz on the bottom there. See now, couldn't see, there's my bivvy on the other side there. I couldn't see anything from over there. I come round here, and that is definitely fish feeding. Be as quiet as I can. Yeah, it's just stopped now, but it was only a little fizz. But that was exactly what I'm looking for. Just those small little signs. It's stopped now, but I saw it. The important thing was that I saw it, and it's only just this, about a rod length and a half off the bank. And that's where I've seen them before, and also caught them before. So I know, now I know where to look. But that's the importance of being mobile and looking, getting off the your backside and getting around the lake and looking. Don't matter how small the lake is, those signs are what you need to find. And sure enough, yeah, it's only a small sign, but it's enough. I know that there's fish just out there. And they're turning up the bottom a little bit, so they can be caught. If they're feeding, they can be caught. Yeah, the rest of the surface just looks absolutely still, like a mill pond. But I know if I keep looking, there will be little signs. Excellent. That's what I wanted to see. Show. It's been quiet for a couple of days. I was thinking about redoing a rod, maybe with a fruity pop-up instead of the citrus wafter, and out of the blue it's just gone off. God, lovely evening as it goes. Yeah, it's picked up some branches or something. Yeah, it's all tangled on something. Come on. We've got him.
It's been cold the last few days. We had a couple of frosty mornings. It definitely switched the fish off. And we knew it had, but was seeing a few signs this afternoon and a few bubbles here and there. And then, yeah, as you saw just now, out of the blue, one of them went off. It was this one, £30.12, lovely mirror. And God, they're in such good condition at this time of year. I mean, they always are here anyway, they're lovely fish. But they're in their prime sort of winter weight, winter condition. And yeah, it was just lovely to catch it. So there we go. It's just a matter of being patient, really. But that's number five now. So, you know, for winter fishing, December fishing, it's good stuff. So I'm well happy with that. Very happy, in fact. After a couple of days without a fish, it was really nice to get a bend in the rod again, for sure, even if it wasn't one of the bigger fish in the lake. But things were looking up, the weather was improving a bit, the temperatures were rising, and the baits were all in position nicely. And the next afternoon, it all kicked off. Well, what an amazing hour. I've literally just put a 38 back, and I just went in to download the pictures off onto the laptop, and another one's gone off, and believe it or not, it's another 50 mirror, £50 8. So that, the first 50 cob and now the first 50 mirror. Just look at that. Look at this. And literally we just got this in the net and one of the other rods has gone off. With a 32 mirror on the end, but it's so strong, this fish. Literally three fish inside an hour. Whew. But that is, that is the prize, £50 8 ounce, 50 common, and now 50 mirror. Oh, just put him down for a sec. There we go. I think that's all it's going to let me do. What an absolutely gorgeous fish. Yeah, that'll do. Oh, amazing. What a place. That great spell of action came right towards the end of December, but what a brilliant way to see out the year, seeing it out in style. New Year's Eve, more celebrations were planned. John Noel once again invited loads of friends and family down for a celebration, and so everything was organised, and there was a little firework display as well going on. Unfortunately, he did set all the fireworks off about 10 yards from where my baits were, so any thoughts of catching one that night were put on the back burner, and yeah, it was time to celebrate instead, which was what we did. Last afternoon on the lake. And it's been dead literally for 3 days now. And out of the blue, off it goes. I redid this rod yesterday actually. Cold northerly wind. I'm literally packing everything down, the bivvies down. I was just gonna sleep in the conservatory tonight. Not expecting anything to happen really.
And there we go. You really never know when it's going to go, do you? Beautiful, nice fish. Yeah, it's a good one. Lovely.
Well, it is the last day of the trip today, but it is January the 2nd, so first cup of the year, first cup of 2019. So that's lovely, because it's been quiet. It's been three days on the trot without a bleep, actually. It's been very quiet. Out of the blue, it's gone rattling off, and it's an absolute cracker. 44-12 it is. Lovely mirror. There we go. What a peach of a fish. It's amazing how these secret garden carp have grown on, actually. Last time we was here, I caught what was my best one from here at the time, £39. This time we've had, well, this is the third 40 plus the 250s, so that just shows how they've grown on and come on in a short time, really. But yeah, what a great place, and what a lovely way to end. I mean, this is sort of, when it has gone off, there's been a few bites in quick succession and sort of around this time of the day, so it might not be the last one, but if it is, it's a nice way to end and a nice way to start the new year. So yeah, happy new year everyone, and what a great way to get it off in style, eh? Secret Garden 40, 44-12. Well, there we go, time's up. It's a lovely morning. It is a bit of a frosty one for sure. It's cold, freezing cold actually, but yeah, it's going to be a nice day. Probably a chance of a bite or two this afternoon actually, but like I say, time to get these away anyway, load the van and head off to England again. So for now it's over, so until the next time, keep fishing, be lucky.